So this is what we've been building up towards this entire chapter, is to be able to solve a rational equation. Equations that contain one or more rational expressions are called rational equations. These equations are often easier to solve once the fractions are eliminated. And that's a good plan, because I know that many of you don't like dealing with fractions. So the very first thing we can do is eliminate the fractions from the equation, and then it becomes like a much easier Algebra 1 style question. The way we can eliminate the fractions is by multiplying each side by the lowest common denominator, or abbreviated the LCD. So that's what we're going to do on the first example. We are going to start out by multiplying both sides of the equation by the lowest common denominator. So I have the denominator of x plus 3, a denominator of 6, and a denominator of 18. So what is the lowest common denominator of those three terms? There is the binomial term x plus 3, so we are going to have to multiply both sides times that term x plus 3. And then we do have just the numbers 6 and 18, so what is the lowest common denominator of 6 and 18? Well, 6 goes into 18, so it would be 18. So we are going to multiply both sides of the equation times 18x plus 3. Every term gets multiplied times 18x plus 3. So when I take 18x plus 3 times 4 over x plus 3, the x plus 3s are going to cancel each other out. So I can cross those out. So the x plus 3 cancels out with the x plus 3 up here. And what that does just leaves me with 18 times 4, which is 72. Now, when we take the lowest common denominator times 5, 6, the x plus 3 isn't permanently canceled out. We're not going to do just 18 times 5. We are going to take the whole thing times x plus 3. So I'm going to go ahead and rewrite that x plus 3 in there. And what cancels on this one is that 6 cancels out with 18. 6 goes into 18 three times. So we're going to take 3 times 5, which is 15, and then we have to take that times the quantity of x plus 3. And then we're going to set that equal to whatever 23 over 18 times 18x plus 3 is. Well, the 18s cancel on that side, so that will leave me with 23 times x plus 3. So multiplying both sides by the lowest common denominator eliminated all the fractions from the equation, and it makes it a much easier question to solve. So we can go through the following steps fairly quickly. So I will distribute. So that will be 15 times x and 15 times 3. So that gives me 15x plus 45. And distribute 23 times x and 23 times 3. So that will equal, 23x plus 69. And let's combine what like terms I have. So I have 72 on the left side of the equation, 72 plus 45. So that's going to be 117. So 15x plus 117 equals 23x plus 69. And let's get the x's on one side of the equation. So subtract 23x from both sides. So negative 8x plus 117 equals 69. Subtract 117 from both sides. So negative 8x equals negative 48. And then divide by negative 8. So we get an answer of x equals 6. With these rational equations, sometimes we modify the equation, get the correct answer, or get an answer, but we do need to check it with the original problem to make sure that it doesn't give us denominators of 0. Because if we have an x value that gives us a denominator of 0 in the original problem, then it can't possibly be a solution, because we cannot have 0 in a denominator. We only have one denominator with an x, and that's the x plus 3 up here, the x plus 3. So when you take 6 plus 3, you get 9. So that doesn't give us the denominator of 0, and so that means this definitely is the correct answer. So let's do another one, another example. So what's the common denominator on this one? Well, 12 goes into 48, so 48 is going to be part of the common denominator. And there is the binomial term x minus 4. So our common denominator will be 48x minus 4. Both sides of the equation will be multiplied times 48x minus 4. So 12 goes into 48 four times. So we will take 4 times 7, which is 28. And then on the next step, I'll distribute that with the x minus 4. And again, remember, the 48 is not permanently canceled out because we're still taking the original common denominator times the second fraction. And x minus 4s will cancel on that. So we'll have 48 times 9, and that is 432 equals, the 48s cancel on this side, so we'll just have to have 55 times x minus 4. And then I'll do my distributing, so that will be 28x minus 112 plus 432 equals 55x minus 220. Let's see, like terms. So negative 112 plus 432 will be 320 equals 55x minus 220. And if I get my x's on the same side, so subtract 55x from both sides, that's 55x. So that will give me negative 27x plus 320. Equals negative 220. Whoops, I don't know what happened there. Subtract 320 on both sides. So negative 27x equals negative 540, and now divide by negative 27. So I get x equal to positive 20. Does that make sense with the original problem? Well, if I replace the x in x minus 4, I do not get a denominator equal to 0. So this is my correct answer. Here's another one with multiple polynomials in it. And when I see that quadratic polynomial in the denominator of the second fraction, or at least the second rational expression, it sure screams to me that I need to try to factor that out. So when I factor this out, I get x plus 5, x minus 3, and notice the other two fractions, the other two rational expressions have an x minus 5, and excuse me, that should be an x plus 3. I get x plus 3, and so that is my common denominator. So I'm going to multiply both sides times x plus 5, x plus 3, and that's what I'm going to do to eliminate the equation of fractions. So when I have x plus 5, x plus 3 times x plus 5, so those x plus 5s will cancel. That will leave me with 2x times x plus 3. And then on the second time, and I've got to erase because remember that on the second fraction, I've got x plus 5, x plus 3 times a denominator with x plus 5, x plus 3, so everything cancels. So it just leaves me with minus, and this is a tricky part, you're subtracting that entire second fraction, so I need to put the entire numerator in parentheses. So x squared minus x minus 10 equals, and then the x plus 3s cancel on this side, so that's 3 times x plus 5. Lots of distributing on this one, so 2x squared plus 6x minus x squared plus x plus 10, so I changed all the signs in the parentheses because of the minus out in front, equals 3x plus 15. And let's see, I got a lot of like terms on this one. So 2x squared and negative x squared, that's just going to be 1x squared. I've got 6x plus x, and that's positive 7x plus 10 equals 3x plus 15. And since I do have a quadratic equation, I have an exponent of 2 in there, I am going to have to get this set equal to 0. So what I want to do on this one is I'm going to move everything to the left side. So I need to subtract 3x from both sides and subtract 15. So I'll put it under the like terms. So that'll be x squared plus 4x minus 5 equals 0. And this is factorable. So that's x and x, and positive 5 times negative 1 is negative 5, but it adds up to 4x. And then set each part of those equal to 0, so x plus 5 equals 0, x minus 1 equals 0, and that gives me potential solutions of negative 5 and positive 1. And I say potential solutions because remember that if those solutions make the denominator equal to 0, then it can't possibly be a solution. And right now, as I look at x equals negative 5, when I plug that into the original problem up here, negative 5 plus 5 would be 0, which means negative 5, even though we came that came up as a solution, it can't possibly be a solution because it doesn't work with the original problem. When I plug in x minus 1 into the denominator here, I get 1 plus 5, which is 6, and that's okay. Over here, 1 plus 3 is 4, that's okay. And in the middle expression, that would be 1 squared plus 8 times 1 plus 15. And you don't even really have to multiply it out. You could just say, hey, I know that all of those are positive numbers, and I know that's definitely not going to be a 0, so it works for the middle expression as well. So this one is the only solution. So x equals negative 5 is not a solution, but x equals 1 is. Here's another example. So what's my common denominator? Well, let's factor this out first. And when I factor it out, I get it's factored into z plus 1 and z minus 1. So my common denominator is just going to be z plus 1 and z minus 1, both sides. Minus 1 there. Okay. So the z plus 1's cancel, leaving me with 2 times z minus 1. And I'll rewrite that z plus 1 in there. And now the z minus 1's cancel. So this will be negative 1 times z plus 1 equals, and then everything cancels on the denominator on this one, so just equals negative 2. Do your distributive properties. So 2z minus 2 minus 1z minus 1 equals negative 2. So again, I just do the distributive property on that. Like terms. So I got 2z minus z. That's just z. And I have negative 2 minus 1 is just negative 3 equals negative 2. Add 3 to both sides. And z is already by itself, so z equals 1 is my potential solution. But as soon as I stick that into the middle denominator up here, z minus 1, 1 minus 1 is 0. That gives me 0 as a denominator, which is not possible, which means the one solution that I came up with can't be a solution. So there's actually no solutions to this rational expression. There are no numbers I can plug in for z and get a real solution.